Hello friends, I'm delighted to welcome you to this webinar series on Automate to Accelerate Progress, in which we will discuss the key features of E2Tallysoft. Thank you all for joining for this webinar. I am C. Abdul Rafiq, Managing Director of Windsor Infotech Limited. These are the four key learning objectives I have set out for this webinar of today. We will take about 45 to 50 minutes. The first learning objective is why to automate import to Tally. Most of you would be using Tally, and you know in Tally, you have to first create the masters and then you can enter the transactions. Is there a way you can automate this data entry of masters and transactions in Tally? That's what we'll discover through this webinar. Next, how to automate import to Tally. And then third, we'll have a walkthrough of the key functions of E2Tallysoft. And then we'd like to spend about 30 to 35 minutes on demo of the key features of E2Tallysoft. Let's have a quick overview of our company. We aspire to be a global leading solution provider in data analytics. And primarily our focus is on empowering professionals to realize the potential of technology by applying thought to technology. We are placed in a unique situation because we revolutionize assurance, compliance, and consulting services by providing powerful tools and techniques for CAs and CXOs for performing data analytics, business intelligence, and AI solutions. This is our strategy. We believe in developing innovative software solutions which empowers CAs and CXOs to harness the power of technology so that you can provide value addition using your knowledge and skill sets. This approach, using technology, you should be able to scale up faster and grow faster in a much lesser time. The focus on how can you use technology in a much bigger way so that you can be much more productive and much more effective. So our solutions are made for the new age digital auditor. We strongly believe in this digital age, every auditor has to be a new age digital auditor. Otherwise, they will be considered as computer illiterates and will not be able to use our skill sets effectively. We need to learn how to future-proof our career and accelerate our growth. And this is what is possible through technology and technology solutions. And that's what we aspire to do. These are resolve for clients for 2021 and beyond. And if you have to just look at one bottom line, we believe in making insightful analytics simple. We know that we are living in a world where we are flooded with data, but we are starving for information. We are flooded with information, but we are starving for knowledge. We are flooded with knowledge, but starving for wisdom. We believe in powering data analytics solutions so that you can focus on using your analytical ability to be much more productive and effective. Now let's get started. Why to automate import to Tally? The problem statement. Creating masters and data entry in Tally requires time and expertise because it has to be done manually. Now the question is there a faster and easier way for creating masters and entering transactions in Tally? Second, the data exported from Tally to MS Excel is not properly formatted to facilitate analysis. So the question is it possible to export masters, transactions, and reports from Tally in a structured format for easier analysis? This is where we provide our solution, E2Tallysoft. This is an automated solution. It's an add-in to MS Excel. It helps you in importing masters and transactions of accounting, inventory, cost centers, and bill-wise from MS Excel templates to Tally in a few clicks. And the learning curve is very, very short. In fact, most of our clients are CAs and their article clerks are using this most effectively for providing accounting related services. What used to take hours and hours now can be done in a few minutes. So we have been able to save thousands of hours for hundreds of CAs across India. And you could be one of them. So what we are looking at is how do we automate input to Tally? And this automation of input to Tally, there are also RPA solutions which mimic the Tally data entry process. And now we have proven, and you'll also see as we go on when we give the demo, that in E2Tally soft, we directly convert the data in the way Tally requires, and it's much more faster compared to any RPA solution. So the bottom line is E2Tally soft helps you as an automated conversion tool for importing information of masters and data from MS Excel to Tally in a few clicks. Now this gives you a synopsis. You got the data in MS Excel templates, and you use our solution E2Tally soft, and you can use the masters and vouchers, and you can import to Tally directly. These are the salient features. Why do you need to use E2Tally soft? It supplements the powerful features of Tally with the simplicity of MS Excel, which means you can import from transactions from Tally, from Excel to Tally, thousands of transactions in a few minutes. Similarly, you can also do the reverse way, which means you've got data in Tally, you'd like to export the data in Excel in a structured fashion, you can do that. Who can use it? Any user of Tally, whether an accounting business owner or assurance professional, you can use it. How to use it? I'll show you. It's very, very simple to use. You can select the modules depending on what you want, whether you want to import accounting inventory or accounting with the inventory or accounting with BillWise cost center. What will be the module you want to use? You select that particular module, select that particular master and the vouchers as required and import into Tally in a few clicks. When do you use? Whenever you want to automate the process of importing the masters and vouchers from Excel to Tally, you can use E2Tally soft. There are CAs who are providing accounting services where they have to, let's say, do data entry of more than 2,000 transactions in a month. Now, manually, if this was done, every transaction, let's say, takes 2 minutes, it would have taken about 4,000 minutes, or average of about, let's say, per day, an employee works 200 minutes, which means it would have taken, or 400 minutes, it would have taken 10 days to do the data entry of this 2,000 transactions. But you'll find, using E2Tally soft, this can be done in less than 10 minutes, as long as the data is available in a digital format. There are many companies who maintain or who get reports. For example, somebody is selling on Amazon. He gets the data from Amazon. He can download the Excel sales data, and directly you can import it into Tally in a few clicks. So what can you do with E2Tally soft? This summarizes the discussion we had so far. You can automate import of masters or transactions from MS Excel to Tally and thus avoid manual data entry and related errors. This will save you enormous amount of time and money and also enhance your effectiveness and increase productivity of you and your team. Now let's look at the second, how to automate. Now let's get quickly into how to use E2Tally soft to import data of masters and transactions. These are the 7 key features. Automate import in bulk from Excel to Tally using standard templates of data of masters or vouchers. Import masters or vouchers, accounting, inventory, cost centers, and BillWise from Excel worksheets to Tally. You can also export, like I said, the reverse of import. You can also export masters or vouchers reports from Tally to Excel in a structured format for further analysis. This maintains an automatic log of all the activities you perform so that you can use for future reference. You can generate specific company info, statistics, and index sheets for documentation. And not only that, it has some key features or utilities such as validating patterns of PAN, TAN, GSTN, and other standard formats. And you can also, as I said, export masters, vouchers, trial balance. And not only that, you can also consult TB of multiple companies. Now, if you have to summarize the whole thing in a few steps, this is what happens. You can open Tally, select the company and the period for which you want to import the data. Open MS Excel and click on the tab of E2Tally soft, and then click on the specific function and use alert options and review the results and confirm results are as required or as planned. Now, if you want to import masters and vouchers of accounting from MS Excel to Tally, because this is the most important feature of E2Tally soft, this gives you the 7 step. I'll also explain and demonstrate to you the 7 steps. Let me quickly show the 7 steps. The first step is open Tally, select company and the period for which you want to import the data. Second, open MS Excel and click on tab of the E2Tally soft. This should take a few seconds. Download the template. Now it's important that you can have your own templates, but the template should be in the format in which we have designed. You can download the template. We have given templates with sample data and templates with ready to fill. So you can use whatever format you want. Next, you can import, as I said, accounting inventory cost center of bill-wise data. This could be pertaining to the masters. First, you create the masters. It's a new company, or it's an existing company. If you want to add any masters, you can use it. You can also import the vouchers as required. And these vouchers could be accounting, or accounting with inventory, or accounting with inventory and cost center, or accounting, inventory, cost center, and bill-wise. Whatever be the combination, you can import the vouchers. Now, first, in terms of selecting the masters to import, this masters could be pertaining to the accounting. And in case of accounting, tally requires groups, ledgers, and voucher types, or you can import all of them at one shot. In the case of inventory, you have the masters of units, go down stocks. In stock, you have groups, items, and categories, and you also need to import currencies. In the case of cost center, you have cost category and cost center. Import masters data and confirm. You import the master data of groups, ledgers, and voucher types, and review the results. Five, you download the templates of sample data vouchers. Now you've done the masters. Now you want to go to the vouchers. You download the templates of sample data vouchers. So review and add the relevant data in the worksheets in the required format. Okay, for example, I've given you the link where you can download this. I'll also show it to you in a few minutes. So you decide which are the vouchers you want to import, whether it's accounting, inventory, or cost center, or bill-wise. And now in accounting, it could be we are not selling like other companies specific modules for specific voucher type. We give you all voucher types. And in inventory, it could be any type of inventory transactions and cost transactions. You can do all of them at one shot, or you can selectively do for specific type of transactions. And once you imported the voucher data, it's always important to confirm whether the results you got is as what you wanted. So how do you do this? You can look at statistics, which is generated by the software. You can go to the daybook of tally and confirm whether the transactions have been correctly and completely imported. You can also use the DSS module in tally, which means you go to statistics, and then based on that, look at the number of vouchers which are there. You can also look at the impact in the balance sheet and the profit loss account or the TB. You can also check the import log, which is created for the master vouchers when the data is imported. In case there are any errors, tally will also show you errors, what are the errors and where it stopped importing. Now that you got the concepts right, now let's get into specific functions of EQtally Soft. Now, before I go further, let me take you to the website. This is the website of WinCat. Now, if you come to this particular solution, now actually, I'm actually in EQtally Soft. If you go to the website, you'll be able to get complete idea of what this EQtally Soft is all about. The key choose salient features, okay, import masters. We also got recorded webinars and videos of how to use the software. Because some of the concepts I'm covering in quickly. So if you want to go further and dig deeper, you can also go to this particular web, go to a website and see details. Let me come to one particular area. You also got use cases. Let's say we go to functions. Now, this functions gives you the complete list of functions which are available in EQtally Soft. Not only that, it explains to you which is the panel, what are the menu, and what are the function, and what does the function do. For example, if you see Open Tally, it opens Tally software from default or user location with option to open single or multiple companies from the user or the default location. You can also add the company info, which means for any Excel sheet you got, you can add the company info and which will be used for printing. So that becomes a part of documentation. You can also get the system info, the system information of the system which you're used. You can also get general info, which is the masters from Tally. You can export and get the general info, master info, and it also creates an index sheet. You also have Excel log, activity log, and import log. And you have got the masters. This is where you talked about templates. Now, if you look at the templates, you've got templates pertaining to masters, vouchers, and invoice also. Invoice, we just given as a sample reference. If you go further here, you'll see we have, it is actually in 4 pages. Now, once you have downloaded the template and you added the data, you need to validate to confirm it meets the requirements. This is where you use the validate function. You can validate the masters. You can validate the vouchers. You can also validate the patterns, which is what I said is the utility function. For example, you have the GSTN. I want to check whether the pattern of the GSTN is correct. You can use this function. Then you can import the data to Tally. This is where you use import to Tally. We also made the name of the function, the panel, so that it is self-explanatory. So you can import to Tally masters, vouchers, and statistics. Now, if you look at the steps here, first you download the template, you add the data, validate the data, and then you import to Tally, and then you can verify. You can also export. For example, let's say there are a few cases we have where they say the client is maintaining the accounts, the auditor is also maintaining the accounts. So whatever the client has entered, he shares the tally data. which is exported from Tally and imported into the auditor's Tally, and the auditor actually updates the data using the Tally. Okay, this is where we added this new function called export to import, which means you export the data from Tally and then you import either in XML or XLS format, and then you import it in XML or XLS. Now, it could be possible you may not have the data in the required template, and it may be very cumbersome for you to prepare the data in the template. So in that case, we also have a lot of excellent functions, which is called as convert to vouchers. So in this case, most of the cases, we want the software to be very, very user friendly. And that's where we have given you formats for each of these functions. You've got the format for each of the functions. For example, there's a configure and create, and then you have, if you see it, sales or returns, purchase or returns, services or JVs, bank statements, receipts or payments, salaries, and we also got map vouchers. You got a particular format, you want to map the voucher to a particular format, and you can create the vouchers. Once you've created, converted the data in the voucher format, you can import it. You also got import from Tally. This is what I said. You can import from Tally the daybook, which could be the transactions or the ledger vouchers, cash transactions, bank transactions. Individually, you can export from Tally to Excel in a structured format. Okay, this is what we have got. You can also get the trial balance, which could be closing ledger trial balance, ledger wise trial balance, ledger with group period wise, and you can also consolidate. Similarly, you can also import from Tally or export from Tally various types of vouchers or registers. Like you have sales register, voucher wise you can get. You can get a sales extract, you can get sales columnar, you can get sales inventory, purchases similarly for journals. So it means you can export data from Tally to Excel in a structured format. Okay, so you can go to the website. This website, it also gives you information and demos of each of these functions. Now let's go get going. Let me come to the presentation. So these are the panels which are available: configure, profile, documents, template, validate, import to Tally, export to Tally, import from Tally. We also have this presentation uploaded. If any of you require this presentation, you can send an email. We'll share this with you. Now, this is what I talked about. These are all the features of the software, functions of specific functions of the software, import from Tally. Now, let's come to the most important thing, which is talking about the demo of the key features of E2Tally soft. Now, let me show you the demo of import of masters and transactions. Okay, now let me get started. Okay, now let's minimize this and come to Excel. Let me show this also. We also provide monthly updates. Now this gives you the release of March 2021. These are the enhancements we had. We've added the new format for sales returns and purchase returns. We also added functions for sales returns and purchase return. Earlier we did not have, we had only sales. Now we also added sales return, purchase returns, which means you can convert data of sales return, purchase return and convert. And there are bugs, water bugs are identified and reported by customers. We keep on resolving them and rectifying them. So you find in this case, when you install the software, there will be release notes, which tells you what are the new functions or features which have been enhanced. For example, let's say in the January build, we added a feature called configure and create. Okay, like that, it gives you the complete history of all the new features we added in the software with a brief function. For example, in December release, we added a new function called cash and bank transactions. We also removed some of the functions which are not relevant, which are not used. Now let's come back to our place where I want to give you a demo of how the software works, because that's what is most important. So what I'm going to do is, I've got this Excel format. Now if you look here, this is what I said is an add into software. Now this is Excel. Okay, Excel has the software. Once you add the software, now this is an add in tab. So you have this E2Tally soft. When you click on this, all these functions are the functions which are available exclusively in E2Tally soft. Similarly, now there's one more software we got called ECAT Enterprise. These are the exclusive functions which are in ECAT Enterprise. Yesterday I did a webinar on ECAT Enterprise. If you'd like, you can watch it. You can also see the details, recording of the ECAT webinar. Similarly, tomorrow I'm going to do a webinar on TCAT. TCAT is an exclusive software for exporting the data from Tally to Excel. Plus, it also has got various types of analysis features where you can perform analytical procedures using the data from Tally once you import it into Excel. Now let us focus on E2TallySoft and get started. Now this is what I was talking about. If you look at the configure panel, these are the functions available. Open Tally company info and system info. When I click on system info, see now it gives you a brief information about your system. Just a simple utility. When you say general info, it gives you the master data. Now when you see, click here, general info, it gives you the company info, company features, security features like that, which means these masters are exported through a single query from Tally to Excel. This becomes a part of your audit documentation. Similarly, you look at master info, you can get all this type of master data directly from Tally to Excel in a structured format in one click, which means if I just select all and say yes, it'll create all this. Not only that, it'll also add an index sheet. Tomorrow I'll give a detailed demo of this when I cover TCAT. Some of the features of TCAT are also included in E2TallySoft. And I also covered this earlier. So I want to focus more now on the new functions which are there. Now index sheet only adds an index sheet telling you which are the new sheets which are created. I'll show this function a little later. We also, I talked about documentation. We also got Excel log, which meant as a complete list of all the functions you performed in Excel. And you can open the file location directly from here. This is what I said is part of the audit documentation. All the activities you performed in the software, it gives you along the function name, the company name, performed at, workbook name, worksheet name, file path where the data is stored. All this data is captured as a part of the audit documentation. So it means what are activities you perform using E2TallySoft, this is captured. This is an import log, which where you will get the import log from done in Tally. What are the data which is imported? This is given directly by Tally. So when Tally gets the data inside in XML format, it creates a particular format and then we directly open this and show it to you. Okay, in this case, we are not open Tally. Now let's get started with the template. Now, if you look at the templates, we have got the masters, vouchers, and the invoice. The invoice is just only for the purpose of the demo, saying if you want to use the standard template, you can use the invoice template. It doesn't have anything to do with accounting inside Tally. Similarly, you validate the data, then you import to Tally. So there are only three steps if you want to get the transactions from MS Excel to Tally. First, you download the template, add the data, validate and confirm whether it meets the requirement, and then you are ready to import. What I'll do now is I'll get you started one by one. Okay, let me open Tally Prime. This is already open. I'm going to create a new company. Now I've got this company, so let me call this as a webinar demo, March 21. Okay, now here I've got the data, sample data, which is from 1st April 2019. So I'm going to create this company, that's all. Okay, so let me say, okay, I don't have any VAT as such for the timing, I'm just taking this, just to simplify, which means I'm creating a company. Now maintain accounts, yes, you can decide whether you want to maintain account-wise, bill-wise, all this data is available, maintain inventory. So for the time, let's say, I'm just going to say no. Okay, which means I'm going to just show you a demo of only accounting. Okay, I can select the state. Let's say I select Karnataka. This is done regular, yes. Now the company is created, okay. Now if you want to see the data, ESS, now you find these are the default groups, ledgers, and voucher types which are available in Tally. Now I'm going to start with the first step. Now I'm coming back to Excel. I come to Excel. Now let's look at the template. Now I'm going to come into the template masters. Okay, if you see this, it's very, very simple. I've got import, accounting, inventory, cost center, and bill wise. So these are the two modules, accounting and inventory. The add-on modules are cost centers or bill wise. Now here, what I do is I'm going to select only accounting in this case. Okay, and I say, as I said, you have the sample data or ready to fill. First, I'm going to show the sample data. I said open. Now it gives you a message. Do you want to open fresh sample data? I say yes. Now this opens. The first thing you get is a guideline. Please read the guidelines, because using the guidelines, many of us customers have been able to use it. It tells you what exactly we do, what are the format in which it's going to be there, and what are the validation which is done through the software. And you can also ensure the data meets this requirement. Now I've got groups. I have this is the standard data. I've got groups. Now this is a format in which the groups have to be given. Now what is given red font, red color font, is actually the data which is mandatory. Now you got the ledgers. and then you got the voucher types. Now, one important point which you have to remember, whenever you're creating a group name and it has got subgroups, the first, the higher hierarchy has to be created first. Otherwise, Tally will not be able to import it. Now, I've got these groups. Now, I've also created statistics. So in this case, this is statistics of the data which is available inside this. Now, first thing I would like to do is I would like to create these groups. Now, how many, if you look at the statistics, there are 69 groups, 258 ledgers, and 25 voucher types. I'd like to import this data. How do I go to import this data? I just go to eTallySoft. Look at the simplicity. I'm just going to go to import Tally, and what I want to import is the masters. Now, it'll read the column names, and by default, it is selected groups, ledgers, voucher types, because that's what is available. Sorry. Now, you don't have cost center bill wise. If it was there, you'd have given. I'm not considering attendance as of now. Simple. Now, what I have to do is I've already opened the company, which is there. I've already shown you. I created the company. I've also opened the company for the accounting period. It tells me this is the company. It's always advisable to keep only the active company open because the data will go into that active company. Now, you see, the import has started. Groups already imported. Now, it's importing the ledgers 258. In a fraction of a second, it's already done. Now we imported the voucher types. Okay, now it also gives you a summary. What are the voucher types which have been imported? I say yes. Now it adds you a summary, statistics of what are the vouchers which have been imported. Now if you look at this data, in the ledgers, I have the opening balance also given with the debit and the credits. Okay, now let's come to Tally and check what has happened, whether it's actually done the job. Now I come to statistics again. Now if you see here, the magic, the groups have been created, additionally groups. Now the ledgers have been created, what are ledgers I wanted, and the voucher types additionally have been created. Now this, how simple it is to import the masters. Okay, now this I showed you example of accounting. The same way, let's say I want to use this template, I can go to masters and I say I want ready to fill. I just say ready to fill, I say open. It'll give me a blank template where I can add the data. Okay, with the same thing. Now, if you see this little bank template, it tells you what is the format in which you have to give the data. Now, this is how easy it is to update the masters. Now, let me say I want to pick up the masters with inventory. I just select the inventory and I say with sample data. I'll say okay. Now, if you see, I got this data. Now, you see the additional one. We've got the guidelines, which is always there. This will also include guidelines for inventory. Group, ledgers, units. Now these are all the item masters pertaining to the inventory. Okay, it also talks about what is the validation which is done for inventories. In each of the category, what is the validation which is done? Now we've got the groups, ledgers, voucher types. In addition to that, we've got the masters of units, godowns, stock group, stock categories like that. Okay, this is how simple it is to import the masters. I've done this one for maybe hundreds of companies where we provide accounting as a service. We have done this automation. Now we have done the masters. Now let's go and import the vouchers. How do I import the vouchers? I just go to the templates, vouchers. Now in this case, I've taken accounting. I'm going to take accounting. I'll say open. I have some sample data here. Now these are the guidelines for vouchers. Okay, read the guidelines, it's very, very simple. It tells you what is done. Then I've got this vouchers. Now here, if you see, I've got all the voucher types in this. Okay, I've got contract, rate note, debit note, all these things. And this gives you the format in which the data is available. Which are the mandatory fields that are given in the red color font. Okay, these are all the data which can be captured. Now what happens if you don't have the data? If the data is there, it will be captured. If the data is not there, in the case of non-mandated data, that is not captured. If the mandate data is missing, it will give you as a validation mistake. Okay, this is how the data has to be provided. Now I'm going to import. Let's look at the statistics and see what happens. Now if you see, totally there are 916 vouchers. Now do we have, in Tally, do we have any vouchers? If you see here, if you come to statistics. Okay, now you see there are zero vouchers. Now I'm going to come to Excel and then select eTallySoft. This is what I got. Now, if you look at the number of rows, what are the number of rows? There are 2,436 rows. Now, let's see the magic happen and let's see how much time it will take for us to create or import this vouchers. Now, what do I do? Here, if you see, I have to import. What is my job? I want to import. I can also do the validation, or by default, it will do the validation when you're importing. Now, it gives me that it's only accounting. It is recognized. These vouchers are only accounting. How does it recognize? Because based on the column names, okay? I can also do an auto numbering of vouchers, which means it will ignore the numbering what you have given and automatically give with the serial number 123. Not only that, if previous vouchers are there, and let's say you already imported vouchers 40, now for sales, then for sales voucher, it will add the vouchers from now on as 41, 42, etc. Similarly, purchase vouchers, you already have, let's say 32. Now, when you say auto numbering, it will take the next numbering from 33, 34, like that. Okay. I'll say, okay. Now, see the same pattern. It does the validation checks of which is the company which is open. I'll say, okay. Now, please validate before importing. I say, yes. Now, it'll do the validation. It now, as you see, it also gives a message. What are the type of validation it's doing? In this case, I've already validated, ensured that all the data is correct. Now it started importing. Just look at the time. It's 15:30 now, 17:30. Now it's importing 916 vouchers. Okay, let's look at what the time it takes to create this 916 vouchers and add it inside Tally. Now let's talk about the RPA solution. The RPA solution for Tally mimics the manual solution. In that case, it reads the Excel sheet one by one, row by row, opens Tally and posts a transaction like you do manually. Now, manually, you may take 2 minutes to post a transaction. See, now within less than a minute, we have been able to import 916 vouchers. It said created 916 vouchers. It gives you the type of vouchers which are imported. I'll say statistics. Yes, I want to retain the statistics. Now, if you look at this is what is the statistics added. So these are the total number of vouchers added in 916. Now, I can't believe this. Let me go to Tally and cross check. I go to Tally here. I come back again. Now, see the magic. 916 vouchers have been imported. Now, what is the difference between a voucher which is imported and the voucher which is available in Tally? Because I'm using the demo version, so that's why I've given only two dates. Now, I see there's no difference between the data which is available when you manually enter in Tally and the data when it is imported. Now, just imagine if you're providing an accounting service and you get this data. Now, you have to just get this particular data in the format. And you see 900 vouchers, just imagine even you take 1 minute, the accountant is very fast, 1 minute per voucher, it's going to take about 916 minutes, which means about 15 hours. And how much time did you take to import? It took less than a minute. And this is the power of automation. Now I've shown you how to import. Now let me come back to the presentation. I've given you a demo of how to import masters and transactions. Now it could be possible that data what you're getting may not be in that required format. Okay, for example, let's say a mining company does the mining and they have a separate software for mining, and from that they generate a report. And the report pertains to all the sales which has been made. There are about 2,000 transactions. It has got different fields. Okay, they give this data and they want you to import in Tally. Now, it doesn't really make sense to go and format the data and create it in template. For that, you've got one more thing where you can convert the data which is in a specific format to the sales format. Now, let me give you a demo of the conversion of sales, because this is the most critical function which is extensively used. I'll come to Excel. Now let me close this, which is already done. Now you're seeing how simple it is to use the software. Okay, is there any other Excel open? No. Let me come back here to Excel. This is what I've got. Now what I'm going to do here is, yes, this is what I've got. I have convert function called convert to vouchers. Now I was talking about one more thing, let me show. I have this export. Now let's say I want to export. I say, what is that I want to export? Now, yes, I told you, remember, we talked about export to masters. I say export masters. I decide what masters I want to import. Let's say I want to export group ledgers and voucher types, which means what are data I have imported into Tally. Now I have to select the folder where I want to import this data. Now let's say I put this in desktop and I say, okay. From Tally, it will export the data in the XML format. Okay, so that if I want, I can import the same data directly into another Tally which is being maintained. It tells you what are the vouchers which are being maintained, because the XML format, it doesn't open. Okay, is this file available? If I go to, let me come back to my desktop, you'll be able to see this. Now, if you come to desktop, you'll find this is the voucher type. Now, if you see here, groups, this is what has been created. This is the XML data, which is exported from Tally. Let me open with Notepad. See, now this is XML data, master data, and this is how the data is required in Tally for it to be imported. Each of the rows, it will be a particular data which is given, based on that it will be imported. Okay, I can also export, if you see, come back to the Excel sheet. Okay, now if you see here, I can also export in XLS format. So it means I just say I want an XLS format. I can select what the format I want. I can export the masters. There's one more interesting thing I'll show you. Now I was talking about the master data. I wanted the master info. Now let's say I want the list of ledgers from the data which is already imported. I say okay. Now you see all the masters which are there. Now in a few seconds, I've already got this masters with the index sheet. This is what I was talking about. This is the index sheet. Okay, now if you see here, index sheet. Now it gives me all the ledgers with the parent, primary group, opening balance, closing balance. In a structured format, it gives me this detail. Now let me go to one more master data. I'll say master data. I want, let's say, the list ledger groups. I say ledger groups, okay. Now you see, this should be able to export all the ledger groups, which is the groups which are created inside Tally, and give it to you. I think there was an issue because of which Excel crashed. Sometimes it happens. Okay, so I think we got this ledgers. We had some issue in the export. We'll come to that later. So I was talking about master info. So if you look at the general info, let's say I want the company info. Let's say I select all this info and I say okay. Now you see this is done through the SQL. Now it successfully imported everything. Now, if you see here, this is what I was talking about, the index sheet. It adds the index sheet, security features enabled. I'll get at one glance, the company features enabled, the system info, the strategy info, the license info, everything I get in one shot. Okay, now let's come to the convert format, which I was talking about. Now here, if you see convert to voucher, this is the most extensively used feature. Now here, we also given a sample format so that you can practice. Now let me open the format. Now what are the type of formats? You've got sales, sales return, purchases, purchase returns, services, JVs, you've got bank statement, receipt payment, salaries, and map vouchers. Okay. Now in sales, the data could be in single rate with header as ledger name, single rate with column as ledger name, or it could be multiple rate. Here also multiple GST rates in multiple rows. All this type of sample data is available. I'm going to just show you one example. Here also we have got in the same structure, sample data, and ready to fill. I'm going to open on sample data. Do you want to open sample data? Yes. Now I've got the sample data. Now this particular data, I format it so that it becomes easy to import the data. Now if you see, this is a service company, a CEA who provides data KYC services to a bank through a company which has got. Now this is the data which is available. You have to get the debit and credit clear and know what are the ledger names. In this case, the party name, this is the party name. This is the voucher type which is there. Okay, GSTN you can import or you need not import. You got the invoice number. Now they want the import number, this particular invoice number to be added inside Tally. You got the invoice date, GST sales. This is the amount of sales, this is the output, GST, output CGST. And then you have the debit amount. Okay, now let's see. This data I want to convert into the sales format so that I can import into Tally. So what do I do? I've already got the format. I'm showing you the format so that you can understand. I also have got the same data in a blank format. You can decide what are the data you want. Now I go to sales or returns. Now here I've got sales and returns. It just does some validations. Now it gives me this particular one. I can connect to Tally and select the company, or for the timing, I'm just going to call it ABC. Okay, I can select the sales or sales return. Now in this case, I'm just selecting the sales. Okay, I got the invoice date, voucher type is already selected, voucher number. Now in this, I want to select the invoice number. I just give INV, select the invoice number. Debit name, now this is what is important. I select the party name who's to be debited. This is the debit party name. And it tells you the debit amount will be computed automatically. What is the amount to be debited? We'll come to this a little later. Now in this case, this is a single. Okay, so it means it's a single rate of tax. I come to next. Now if I'm connecting to Tally, I can connect to Tally and add the ledger name directly here. In this case, I'm not connecting to Tally. Now here, what am I going to select? I'm going to select the sales field, sales column, which is the GST sales. Okay, and I add this as a header column, which means for all the transactions, GST sales is going to be created. Here again, for IGST, I have to look at IGST here. I have selected IGST. I have selected here. Next, I can select this CGST. Okay, next, I am going to select the SGST. Okay, this is what I've done. If there is any cess or parking charges, anything like that, I can select that also. That's all. Now, if I want any additional details, I can go to additional details. I can also add, let's say, the transaction type, buyer name, party name, all the data, what is required, I can add. Then I can also add the cost center details, okay, or the bill wise details. If it's applicable, I can add that. I can also add the inventory details. Okay, in this case, I'm not adding any of the details. Okay, I've disabled that. And now I want to convert the data. Which means now see, all the transactions have been converted. It gives a preview of the transactions. Not only that, it also gives you the statistics. Now see, what is the begin date? What is the number of debits? What is the sum of debit? What is the sum of credits? What is the sum of sales? All the details available to you. Now I want to preview the vouchers. I can say preview the vouchers. I get a complete preview of the vouchers. What is the debited? Okay, party's account is debited. GST sales is credited. Output CGST is credited and output SGST is credited. So you see, for all the transactions, these are pertaining to transaction number one. Now what you could do is you can save this. Okay, it says do you want to export this? Okay, I've saved this data. Now if you see here, this data is already formatted in a standard format and you are ready to import this data. This is how the sales transactions are converted. Now let me take you to the next one. Let's say the same thing I have got for the sales return. So I'll just pick up the format of the sales return. Here also I'm just picking up the single rate. I say open. Now here it gives you the guidelines. It also gives you the sample data. Now here some of the transactions which I've done, there's a sales return for this. I've also selected the voucher types of sales return. It could also, in some case, you may have a debit note. If the voucher type is debit note, you can add the voucher, the transaction voucher type as debit note. Now these are the transactions I want to, these are the sales return which I want to account. Now I come to this, eTallySoft. I pick up this option, sales return. Now see the intelligence is built in the software. So that will convert the transaction exactly in the way you're an accountant to do. Okay, now let me come back here. Let me come to Excel. This is a sales transaction you wanted. Okay, this is screen you wanted. Now I add the company name. I can connect to Tally and add the company name. I've just given a sample company name. I can select the narration. Let's say in the narration, I want, let's say the GST number. Okay, I can add a narration field and keep this one. I have to select the voucher number. In this case, I give the trans ID as the voucher number. I give the party credit. Now in this case, sales return, the party credit, which means I have given the, what are the name, supplier name. Okay, the credit amount will be computed automatically. Now in this case, it's a single one, single transaction, single rate. I said next, the same pattern is followed. So that's why it is very, very simple to learn. I select the header name. What are the sales return? I select the column which is supposed to have the sales return. I select the sales return. Similarly, now I have to give the CGST, IGST pertaining to that. I don't have any IGST in this case. So I don't select the IGST. I can just ignore this. Now I come to the CGST. And I got the CGST value. Okay, here I select the SGST. Okay, this is what I've got. Now there is no other thing. If there is any other packing charges, anything which has to be there, that is also taken. Now you see here, just check that amount. I don't need to bother over the total tax amount because automatically converted. So I say convert. Now you see based on this, it gives you summary overview of this. Now I'll look at the statistics. Now it gives me the complete statistics of the transaction is converted. I said preview vouchers. Now this gives me a preview of what the transaction. Now you see the party's account is created, GST sales return is debited, the CGST tax value, the whatever is the ledger name in Tally, you can give the column name and automatically it is taken. Okay, this is how you can convert the sales and sales return. The same way you can also do for the purchase and purchase return. I'll not give a demo, but I'll just show you the format so that you can get an idea. Now I've got this, let's say I just go to the formats. This is how quickly, if you want to learn, you can learn that. Let's say I go to purchase. Okay, I'll say sample data. Now, if you see here, these are the purchase data. Now, how do I convert this? I come to EduTallySoft. I go to purchase, purchase returns. Now here I want the invoice date to come inside. I can also select that as the reference date. Here I, let's say I give the company ABC. I select the invoice date, author type, narration. Okay. Now here I select the voucher number. Which is the voucher number? I select the voucher number, the transaction number, because that is what is going to be taken. I can also add the party's invoice number as a reference number. I select the party credit, which is the supplier name. Okay, now if you see next, what happens in this case, once again, I come back and select the headers. What are the purchase values? Purchase value is CST purchase. What are the ledger that you have given? Give the same in tally, the same thing you give here. Okay, let me convert completely. This one, if there is IGST, is there any IGST? In this case, there's no IGST. So I'm going to deselect this. Now here you got CGST. This is CGST tax value. Okay, here I've got, now this is important. I have to say that this is taken as the header value. Now similarly, I pick up the SGST tax value. That's all. Now I say convert data. Now you see the transaction, how it's converted. This gives a preview. Now I get the statistics. Now this gives me the total sum of the debits, what are the transaction date. Now I want to see the preview of the vouchers. Now look at the beauty of this, because how the transaction is intelligently converted. Now you see the party's account is created, GST purchase debited, the CGST tax value, SGST value, tax value is taken. Now this argument is SGST value. How do you take this as the SGST value? This is based on the column name which I've taken. Now if you see here, what are the column name I have given? Here I've given that as the SGST tax value and CGST tax value. In your case, let's say you're taking that, the client is taking that as. Now here I've given, you can give exactly the ledger name which is there in tally. Automatically it will be taken exactly in the same way, and then you're ready to import these transactions. Okay, now let me show you one interesting thing which is most commonly used, which is the bank statement. Now I've seen you show the sales purchase, similarly purchase return is also there. Let me show you the next one, which is the format. Now I'm coming to the bank statement, which is most extensively used. Bank statement, it can be bank statement, you can have the debit credit in single column, or it can be in two columns. I'm selecting the first one, which is single column. I may take another 5 to 8 minutes. See, you have got the guidelines how to do this. Okay, now I got the sample data here. Now if you see here, the data is not in a structured format, but it is actually the file which is downloaded from the bank in an Excel format. So it's always preferable to download the file in a Excel format rather than a PDF format, because the data will be formatted and structured. Now I'm going to show you how to convert this bank statement into a format which can be imported inside Tally. Now I'm going to go to the bank statement. I give the name of the bank. So in this case, let's say HDFC. If I'm connecting to Tally, I can go and connect to Tally and then give the name of the bank. Okay, now I give the column heading. Here, where the column data start? So this is where it starts, serial number. By default, it'll read what is the last column. I'll say yes. And then I can also say for each of these, now one part of the transaction is available in the bank. The second part of the transaction, you can enter it in two ways. One is you put all this as suspense account, and then you in Tally, you can go and enter the data. Or in this case, what I've already done is I've already added a corresponding ledger, which means for each of the transaction, I've also identified which is the corresponding ledger which is to be debited or credited. Okay, so I select the corresponding ledger. When I select the corresponding ledger, okay, now by default, it's select the transaction date, check number, all these values have been selected. It has also got the voucher number. Now see the magic. I can also select additional data, as I said. I say convert data. See, now you got all this data. Now total value of this, the debit and credit doesn't tally. It is not necessary, because I would have issued withdrawals and pay this and deposit in the bank may not tally. Okay. Now I come to preview vouchers. Now this is where the magic you see. Now, for example, each of the transaction which is there, for each of the rows, the transaction has been created. I just save this in Excel. If I want to make any adjustments in Excel, I can also do that. And then I'm ready to import this data into Tally. Now, how much time will it take to import the data? A few seconds. Now automatically taken the data. Now so there are 65, 650, 668 rows, and this can be imported if all the ledgers are available. This can be imported in less than a minute. Now, if you see, automatically it's also identify the transaction as e-fund transfer or cash transfer or whether it's other type. By default, it takes based on the intelligence which is built in the software. This is how we can import, convert a bank statement. Okay, let me show you one more interesting feature, which is, let's say you got this salary data, or let me pick up the JVs. Now, if you got the JV, see, it follows the same pattern, but let me open the, we are sales, we are finished, purchase returns I've shown you. Now I'm showing you the services or JVs. Okay, now it's important that it should have the right data. So let me first go to the format and pick up the data. This is how you can learn. Now services and JVs. Now it can be single debit or multiple credit, sales column as ledger column, expense. There are multiple ways you can do. I'm just taking the simplest one. The first thing you get is the sample data and also the guidelines. Now this is the sample data which is there. Now just look at, understand the transaction. Now let's say a CA firm is there who does the billing. They do as consulting charges, professional charges, what are they debit, and they have the total amount. So in this case, this is for an apartment where they have, let's say, a single debit and multiple credits. Now painting fund, car parking charges, maintenance charges, they collect from each of the apartments. Okay, this is the name of the apartment owner, A001 Ramachandra Menon, and this is the date on which the transaction happened. All this is journal entries. Okay, now let's see how simple it is to convert. Now same thing, just replace the column names with the column names you want. Now this could be three columns, it could be four columns, five columns, whatever be the columns. You got GST filing fees, this one, what is that? Consulting charges, audit fees, whatever the columns you can have, and then you can also have the name of the party. Just maintain that in Excel, and it, once in a month, you can just import this data into Tally in a few minutes. Now I got this data. Now I want to import the, convert this service as JVs. Now I've got this data. Just see, I have to enter the name of the company. I'm just going to the ABC company. Voucher type. Now this, in this case, this is the journal. It's already voucher type, column is there. Voucher number, now voucher number, generally, I select the serial number, okay? Narration, I can give the narration, what narration I want. Now here, it's very clear. There is a ledger debit, single debit, ledger name and total. Let's get this clear. Okay, ledger name, this is the name of the party which is to be debited, and the total amount to be debited is already here. Now here, the credit is going to be multiple. Okay, I say credit. So what are the things to be credited? You've got this painting fund, car parking charges, and maintenance charges. Clear? Now, if you see here, the columns what you wanted, these are the three columns I wanted to import. Now, based on this, I want to import. I want to convert this data. I say convert. Now, you see, it's already converted. Name of the apartment debited. This party is debited. Correspondingly, parking fund, maintenance charges. As applicable for that particular column, if it is not there, it will not create the transaction with a blank amount. So, it's created all the transactions. I want to preview the vouchers. Now you see, it has created all the transactions. In this case, I have not added narration. I can also add the narration. If I have got a cost category, cost center, I can also add that. I just save this in Excel. Now this data is available and we are ready to import this data. It gives you statistics also. Now this is the data which is in a ready-made format for import. Okay, so I'll show you one last thing before you go. Let's say we got the salaries. I've got this format of salaries. I pick up the salaries, I say open. Now you got this guidelines and I got the sample data. Now these are the transactions which are there. Now let's look at, come back and look at the transactions. I got this salaries data, which I want to convert and create as transactions. Now I can do this two ways. I can do this individually for each of the rows, or I can do in total. Okay, I'll just show you both of them. Now you should be very clear what is that is going to happen. In this case, there are multiple debits, the earnings. In this case, what are the earnings here? Now I'm taking up the basic HRA, variable pay, conveyance, overtime pay, and also got the incentives. Now on the credits, I don't need to take the total because total is computed automatically. Now I come to the credit side. Now here I got PF, ESI, professional tax, salary advance. I don't need to take the total deductions. And then the net amount which is paid, I have to take. What is the salary payable? I just say salary payable. Yes, this is what I've got. Now I can say ledger name or total. So in this case, I'm going to take based on the ledger names. I'm not doing based on the total. When I say total, it'll create only one entry for this. I can also add the cost centers if applicable. I say convert the data. Now you see for each of the rows, the data is created. So you have this debit, okay, and you have the corresponding credits. Now this is how you can create the transactions, convert the data. Now this is ready to import. You have the narration, GST number, everything. Once I got the data, now I can import the data directly into Tally. Okay, so now if you see here, we also have one more function called configure and create, where you would like to combine 2-3 columns and make it as a, create it as a narration, you can do that. Now here you see combine column, and I say combine column, I say I want this cost center, cost category, or I want to combine this column, create as a narration, I can do. I can also total multiple columns, total multiple rows, or I can rename a column. And another interesting thing, what I'm doing now, if I've done it for one, and the same template is being used multiple times, I can also save that as a configuration. Next time when it reads the worksheet with the same column name, it will not ask you to select, it will by default select. Okay, so these are the different features which are available in eTallySoft. I hope you got a general idea. I didn't show payments. Let me show this also in 1 minute. Yeah, I've got this payment. Now let's say payment, if I come to payment, receipt of payment. Okay, I got receipt payment, I got payment. I'm just picking one simple example payment. Okay, now here if you see, I got this payment. The same, see, you got the guidelines, how to, what is to be done. I got the payments here. Now here also, if you see, I got the name of the party, voucher type, cash or bank, and the name. So I'm coming to this function. I'm going to select the receipt of payment. Now here I give the name of the company. I can connect to Tally and pick up this. I'll say this is a payment. It has already picked up the transaction date. I select the voucher number, which is the transaction serial number. Right, now I can give the narration. In this case, I'm going to select the narration. I just give narration, right? Now I've got this is a bank or payment. This is a bank. Name of the party, I've already selected the name of the party. And then I say party ledger name. Here I have to select the bank with the column name. So it means the column cash or bank name. So here I select the cash or bank name. Okay, where the bank is there. If there are multiple banks, it will automatically take. Now here I take, this is the amount. Okay, I already got the amount. Now let's see whether we got all the data. Now if you see here, the transaction is automatically created. I'll say preview vouchers. The vouchers are created. And not only that, it also adds what is the transaction type. Now I can save this in a workbook and then we are ready to go. I can import this into Tally. And when I import to Tally, it will do a validation check whether all the ledger names are available. If the ledger names are not available, it will give you a summary that these are the ledger names which are not available. Okay, I hope you got a good idea of what are the features and what is possible through this particular software. Let me see if there are some sample data. Huh. I just want to show you, just I'll take 1 minute. Let's close this with this data. Now I just want to show you a practical case for one Hyundai showroom. Now in this case, this is the sales data. This is a Hyundai showroom, which is the Hyundai company has given for each of the showroom, this type of a software, which generates the sample data for all the services they do for all the cars. This is the type of data which is available. Okay. Now in this case, first we do analysis, understand what are the columns which are required. So we know which is the voucher number, column number, I select this. And then I decide what are the sales data to convert. I highlight the columns which I want. And then based on that, now I'm showing you, this is how we are able to convert these transactions. Let's say there are about 150 servicing of cars or 200 servicing cars, invoices what they do. Manually, they used to take, let's say about 3 to 4 hours to do the data entry. Now just by formatting this particular data, now all that formatting which I've done, when I do this, what I'll do is I'll say this is a configuration. Next time I open the same Excel sheet, I don't need to do, I have to just go and say convert, it'll convert. And then once I converted, I can import this data. Okay, this is important. So you need to understand the business process and the rules. This is what I said, which is important. Okay, so with this, I'll stop sharing the screen. If you've got any questions, I'll take. I hope you got a general idea of what is possible and what are the features. If you've got any specific questions, very good. Thanks, Anusha. See, we believe in providing solutions which could be most practically useful and save a lot of time for CS. And we have spent lakhs of rupees, but we are selling it at a few thousands. So that's most CS can benefit. And that's what is the mission I've taken in my life, that I should be able to provide technology solutions at very, very affordable rates. And you find you can save thousands of hours if you're able to start using the solution. But initially, you need to invest a little bit of amount of time to understand, and you have to invest a little amount of money. But once you do it, it definitely saves you considerable amount of time. So thank you very much. I took a little more time than estimated, but I hope you got a good idea. If you need, we'll also be conducting regular seminars, and also plan to do recording for individual functions, which I'll do it in a later phase, which I'll share with you. Okay. So thank you very much for joining. I hope all of you had a good learning session, and we look forward to seeing you in the future sessions. Bye.